add this to the list of problems for the unemployed in New Hampshire: anxiety and depression. In this next part of the Job Team series, we look at the emotional impact long-term unemployment can have on someone. Sean McDonald takes a look at how living without a paycheck and rejection takes a toll.
It's just frightening, you know. Where are you going to get your money to feed your kids?
For Jackie Simmons, 2.5 years of job searching is taking its toll. Doing everything right, she's sent hundreds of resumes, had plenty of interviews, and plenty of rejections.
You know, I mean, I have to find something.
It's especially hard because her unemployment ran out months ago. To pay the bills, she substitute teaches and sews quilts.
This one I just did, took me like 4 hours.
But it only pays so much. She's had to fall back on assistance programs, and her kids now fear they may have to move. For someone who wants to earn her living, the waiting becomes more and more emotional.
I think it's just hard because I'm not a slacker. I'm a hard worker, and I have a lot to give, and it's just really hard to just sit here and not be able to do it.
Jobs team member Robert Baniskevich is still able to collect unemployment while his job search continues, but it only goes so far to support him and his wife.
How do you survive? How are you paying the bills?
Meagerly. After taxes, about $170 a week from the state of New Hampshire, and then other than that, I've been burning up my savings.
At 64 years old and losing his savings, he's considering retirement.
It is an option, yes. It's very much. I'm 64. It definitely is an option.
But Robert fears Social Security and savings won't cover his costs, so he's hoping to find more work, even for less pay or part-time.
Money is important, of course, but something where I can, somebody's going to look at my background and say, yes, we can use you. That's what I'd like to say.
Problem is, Robert is one of more than 38,000 Granite Staters currently looking for work. The entire process is emotionally draining.
They often feel a sense of failure. They feel a sense of guilt that they're not providing for their family.
Heidi Page is a mental health counselor. She says unemployment for some can lead to anxiety and depression. Her advice: remember the basics like eating healthy and sleeping enough. Stick to a routine each day. Try volunteering to stay active, and even try taking a vacation or at least a break from the job search.
It will help you that when you do re-engage and look for a job again, you'll be able to be more fully engaged.
Surprisingly, Heidi says, she hears most from people who do have jobs and are stressed out. Often, she says, those people now have more responsibility at work due to job cuts and feel they can't complain.
Instead of doing just their job, they're doing the job of, say, 2 to 5 other people. And they can't do it. And the stress of that is overwhelming for them.
On the upside, at last check, both Jackie and Robert have leads on possible jobs, but both have learned not to get their hopes up just yet. I'm Sean McDonald, WMUR News 9.